I want to tell you about the time my band played the 2011 gathering of the Juggalos.
Downtown Brown.
At the 11th annual gathering of the Juggalos.
It is 2011. Early in the year, my band opened for Insane Clown Posse in Toledo, Ohio, and the show went, eh. Somehow we got invited to do the gathering, so we're like, yes. We just kept saying yes to everything Juggalo related, because why not? The weekend began with us getting pulled over by an Ohio State trooper, and we're sitting in the back of the cop car as they start rummaging through our crap. My ex-girlfriend had purchased a giant plush penis.
Penis.
As the Ohio State troopers are rummaging through our crap looking for drugs, they find a joint. So much for our dreams of playing the gathering of the Juggalos. We're gonna go to jail and it's over. The Ohio State troopers open up the back of our van, and the first thing they do is they pull out the giant plush dick, and they look at each other, and the one cop starts like jerking off the giant plush penis, and the other cop is like, ha ha, and they let us go. They gave us our joint back.
And he walks through the streets winking at the freaks with a 2 liter stuck in his butt cheeks. What is a Juggalo? He just don't care. He might try to put a weave in his nut hair, cause he can give a fuck less what a bitch thinks. He tell him that a butt stinks and all that.
You guys, yeah, dude.
Downtown Brown playing at 2:30.
Okay, so this place, Hog Rock Ranch, it's private property. I believe that the police don't have any jurisdiction over this private land. So as soon as you cross into this private land, it's pretty much like you can do whatever the fuck you want. You can do whatever drugs you want. You could be naked. You could, you know, paint Violet J's face paint on your boobies.
You're a stupid ass dumb fucking idiot.
We were on this like second stage, and it was crazy because the lineup was Bobby Brown.
The one and only Bobby Brown. The man many blame for the downfall of the great Whitney Houston, even.
Original member of R&B supergroup New Edition. What the fuck?
Then the band Kitty and then us, my band Downtown Brown. We're watching Bobby Brown do the Ghostbusters 2 theme song. His band is playing on our gear, which was like, we were super stoked. We were just like, I can't believe Bobby Brown is playing on our gear. It was fucking amazing. By the time we took the stage, it was 5 a.m. If Insane Clown Posse asks you to do something, you just say yes because you know you're going to have a really weird experience. And so to this day, if Insane Clown Posse asks my band Downtown Brown to do literally anything, I will say yes.